Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I realized I was doing my makeup and usually I do one eye before I record the second one. And I was like, wait a minute, I wasn't supposed to do the other eye first. Because I'm so used to doing both eyes at once. I'm not used to just doing one and then showing y'all the other one. So I accidentally did both. So I'm gonna tell you what I did for this eye so far and just continue from there. I got this palette from Amazon and I don't know if you guys heard of it. It's called Pre-Up. It's like a dupe for Morphe palettes. In my crease, I used this red color right here. It looks kind of pinkish. I'm not sure why, but that's how it turned out. Added another color in my crease. I used this little Rimmel palette that I got a few days ago. And it has like a lot of neutral colors in it, like transition colors, as shimmers, you know, the whole nine. The color I used was this little magenta color. It's a matte magenta. And those are the only two colors I used so far, y'all. That was it, I promise, as well. Now I'm gonna go in the same palette. I'm gonna go in with this dark, it's like a red brown, I wanna say. This one, I'm gonna go in with that color and I'm gonna put it in my crease. So I guess y'all just might as well watch me do both eyes. So the brush I'm using, it came with like, the palette came with this little brush. So I use the fluffy part to put it in my crease since it's small. I love me some Daniel Caesar, oh my God. Oh, y'all saw his haircuts. So I'm gonna go in the crease of my eye and just darken that. For me, when I'm doing a cut crease, I have to have something dark in my crease because I feel like that's the only way my eye is gonna like pop out, or whatever color I'm using. Like, so I'm using bright orange today. I feel like that's the only way the bright orange is gonna pop out, like, bow.
You're just gonna go in your crease.
I'm just gonna keep building that color up in the meantime to make it darker. And I go a little bit above my crease line because I'm technically putting, like, where the orange is gonna start is technically starting right at my crease. So you wanna go a little bit above so you can see that dark color.
You hear that?
I'm gonna go in, I'm not sure how to pronounce it. I think it's, starts with a C. It's like corduroy or something like that, but I call it brick. Y'all know brick. Go with this brick color right here, and I'm gonna put that in my crease to darken it. And what I do is I make like a half circle shape. I don't go past my eye when I'm using dark colors in my crease because I just feel like it don't look right, so don't do it. Well, you can do it if you know what you're doing, but I just go based off my eye shape. So you do you.
And I'm just bringing it up just a smidge, like that.
His voice, he can have all the babies. Now I'm gonna go back in with that magenta color with this fluffy brush. I got like a pack of them off Amazon. I'll put the link below in the description box. And you wanna blend that out at the top so the dark colors you used aren't too harsh. Like, you want it to be blended. You're just gonna blend that out at the top. Because me, I like to highlight my brow bone. I don't want to put my eyeshadow all the way up here and then, like, it just don't look right. Don't do it, y'all. Just, I'm going to go in with my concealer, my go-to. 1 minute. So now I'm going to go in with my Toffee concealer to conceal my eyes. And basically what I'm saying is, if you have hooded eyes, when you're concealing a cut crease, you want to go in front of where your eye folds and go over that. You don't want to start exactly where your eye crease is, or else your eye is going to look like your cut crease is going to look very small. So I saw this trick on Twitter. I'm not sure who the girl was, but she was basically saying, if you have hooded eyes, start your cut crease in front of your fold, go over it, and then line it up eventually at your crease.
I think this trick I saw on Twitter, if you have hooded eyes and you're concealing like the beginning of your eye, I saw this one girl, she was saying like you wanna go over the fold of where your eye like folds, like you wanna go. What she did is like there's a little fold here that I have, you see, and you would think I would just crease like that, but when I do that, it doesn't look right. I just feel like you can't see my eyeshadow at all. So what she said is to go in front of the fold and then carve your crease. There we go. Go in front of the fold.
All right, so guys, my phone was acting up. So basically what I'm doing is I'm going in front of the fold of my eye, and then I'm gonna go probably like a little bit over my crease line, and I'm not gonna go past my eye when I'm done concealing my eye. Like I stop right where my eye ends, because I like my cut creases to be blended. I've never tried like the wing cut crease before, so I usually stop where my eye ends, and you're just gonna see me conceal the rest of my eye.
We are going to go in with the orange pigment. You already know I'm gonna be going in with this bright orange color, and I'm just gonna pack that on. We're gonna use this brush and we're gonna pack it all on our crease. I'm just gonna pack that on, guys. See how bright that is? It's crazy. Go back in with that dark color in my Rimmel palette. This one right here. And I'm gonna go back in my crease to define it a little bit more. I'm gonna go back in with my MAC palette a little bit more, because I feel like this shade in here is more darker than my Rimmel palette. So I'm just gonna go in there a little bit though, not too much.
So with this color, I'm gonna put it above where I put my, the dark color that I use in the palette, that brown shade. I'm gonna put this magenta color right on top of it to blend it out so my colors don't look too harsh. You want everything to look smooth.
So I'm gonna go in with this brush I got from Amazon. I got it in like a little brush set. Ooh, focus on me. So I'm gonna go back with that color again and just pack it on the end of my eye. Thank you.
I'm going to go in with a different set of my pigments. What I do is I'm going to highlight our brown bone. And then I do my inner corners, but I usually wait until I have my foundation on to do that. So that's what we're going to do next. This is like the true eyeshadow brush. So now I'm just highlighting my brow bone to make, you know, the look pop just a smidge, you know. You gotta add a little brightness to your life. This highlight is strong. Like, you see that? Like, I can't even focus my camera because it's still gonna be, it's a glare on my face. So, I'm gonna do my face off camera. And then when it comes to the eyeliner and lashes, I will be back. So, un momento. Alrighty, we're back, guys. So I did my full face and now I'm gonna do the rest of my eyes. So I'm gonna do my eyeliner, I'm gonna do my highlight, I'm gonna do my under eye, I'm gonna show you the whole nine. I don't think I'm gonna do a liquid eyeliner with this look just because last time I didn't do liquid eyeliner. I'm kind of getting sick and tired of liquid eyeliner, to be honest with you. I think I'm just gonna put my lashes on and then I'm gonna do white eyeliner for today. So I'm gonna be using Kiss eyeliner. It's in white. I got it from my local beauty supply store. And I'm gonna put that like in the center of my eye, not my whole entire bottom line, but just the center. Bright? I didn't realize how bright this was, y'all. Last time I used it, it wasn't this bright. But then, maybe it's my ring light that's making it look this bright, but I don't know. I'm going with this magenta color again, right here, and put that under my eye. I'm gonna use these little small eyeshadow brushes and just line my eye up. So now I'm gonna go in with the corduroy. Ooh, I don't know what it's called. I'm gonna go in with that corduroy. I think that's how you pronounce it. Color. And my MAC palette. So after we do that, I'm going to do my lashes and then I'm gonna do my inner corners last. You already know what's going on. I don't know, I have two different lashes today. I haven't worn one of them in a hot minute. One of them is like my go-to, so I might do a different pair today. My Michelle Minx. I think, I don't know what, I forgot what style this is in, but I'll list it below when I look at my website. But first, I'm gonna go in my Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. This time, I'm not using the waterproof one. So, this is just a regular one. And I'm gonna put it on my top lashes and my bottom lashes. So now I'm gonna go in with my lash glue. It's the Duo Lash Adhesive, but it's the black one because I feel like it's more stronger than my clear one that I have. So, and I low-key use it like as a little like liquid liner. I don't put the lash glue on my lashes. I put on my lash line because if my lash were to pop off, I could just stick it back on because the glue is already on my lash line. So that's just easier for me. So now, I'm gonna put on my lashes. I use Kiss tweezers to put them on. It doesn't really matter what tweezers you use, but just in case if you're wondering what tweezers I use my Kiss tweezers. I don't know if it's me, but I have difficulty putting on lashes majority of the time because my eyelashes, they curl all the way back and they're super short. So it's not like I can just stick mine on. I mean, I mastered doing it low-key, but before I used to have to like use, you know, these little brushes to hold my lashes down and put the lash on to get it right, and it's so difficult. Ooh. Hold on. Wait a minute. Damn. Ooh. Ooh. Mm. Think I might mess around and add some orange in there. I might add some orange at the bottom. Should I add some orange at the bottom or should I leave it white? I'm gonna add some orange. I'm going back in with Mio Pigments. I'm gonna put some orange at the bottom. I just never tried neon colors at the bottom of my eye before. And I'm gonna dip that in here. Just a little bit though. You don't need a lot. And I'm gonna just line my eye up. I wanna see what this look like. Oh. Wow. Wow, do y'all see this? This is so pretty. Wow. Wow. So pretty. Wow, wow. Y'all, you ever just like do your makeup and you just be like, wow. That's a bad bitch. Like, never heard this before. We're gonna go on with this MAC glitter that I got. It's really, really pretty. Ooh. I lost it. Oh, found it. So it reflects pink. I got it for free when I don't know if you can see the reflection, but it's really pretty. I got it for free when I went to MAC and made my little Z palette. They gave me it for free. So I'm just gonna put that in my inner corner. Ooh, I feel like I'm about to sneeze. Oh. Bless me. And that's the eye look, guys. It's really simple. I feel like I try to make my eye looks as easy as possible for y'all, but it's not difficult. I feel like you take your time out of your day, you practice, you do what you gotta do, I feel like you'll be fine. But I think my next tutorial, I wanna do neon green. I have a lot of colors I haven't used yet. I have a lot of colors in here. Like, I think I'm gonna do something with the neon green and the yellow. You know, make it pop. Like, I haven't even used the pink in here before. I haven't used the purple down here. This is like a white. It's like a crystal color. Like, there's a lot of colors I haven't used yet. Then this has some good colors too in it, so I might consider that one as well. That's that. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you guys recreate it. Do whatever you like with it. Have an idea, you know, what to do if you want to do a bold color, you know. Come to me. Another one of my upcoming tutorials, I'm gonna do a skincare routine because I used to have the worst acne ever. I didn't have like cystic acne, but I was stressed out. I was stressed out like from my ex and a whole bunch of bull crap. So I'm gonna do a skincare routine and tell you guys how I overcame that. Kinda nervous because my face was jacked up. I'm comfortable with my skin now. I know my shit cleared up, so I don't really care. But I'm gonna show you guys what I used. I feel like it was from stress because, like, I went to a dermatologist and they gave me medicine. And I used the medicine, and my face cleared up in, like, I want to say, like, 2 months. But the thing is, now I barely use the medicine. I don't use the medicine at all. I use other alternatives, because I feel like if I felt stuck on the medicine, my face would, like, have a huge breakout if I just stopped using it as a whole. So I took breaks using the medicine until I felt like my skin was good enough to not use it at all. So now I can show you guys how to do a skincare routine without going to a dermatologist, because dermatologists aren't cheap. They're really not cheap. And not everybody has insurance. So I want to show you guys what I use when I bought something actually before I even went, and my face started clearing up a little bit. And then I guess the dermatologist, like, sped up the time period of my face clearing up. So I'm going to show you guys what I use, and I still use it till this day. I need to buy a new one. I hope they still have it, because it's a face wash I got from, I think, TJ Maxx or Ross. I think it was TJ Maxx. But y'all, it's some good stuff, like, just that Ford shit. Thank you for watching. I think, not yet, but eventually I want to do a Q&A as well, or like a chit chat, get to know me, because I know a lot of you guys don't know me. So I'm gonna do like 10 fun facts or something, and I can't wait to see you in my next one. I hope you guys liked my little tutorial, and I'll see you next time. Bye guys. Been living in a wild, trying to get away for a little. Every time you come around, you help me get saved for a little. Baby, we can do things, say we can do things, you know. I've been on you.